Hello everyone, I'm Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the 12th tutorial of StatPro. In this tutorial, we will learn how to assign property to our members. After your structure is modeled in StatPro, you are ready to move on to assigning property to your structure. So let's talk about it. This is our model. I hope you can draw this model. Let's go to 3D render and see our structure. There are beams, columns, and plates. We will assign cross-sectional property to them. Let's close it. To get property dialog box, you have to go to this general option. I am clicking on it. Then the first option is for property. If you click there, then a dialog box pops up and it is the properties dialog box. Assigning property to any structure is typically two-step process. We will first define our property and then we need to assign it to our structure. Let's define some cross-sectional property for our beams and columns. To do that, I have to come on this option. Let's click on it. From this window, you can choose any kind of cross section for your beams and columns. The first one is circular or spiral column. You have to input diameter of your column in this box. Then it will be defined. You can choose rectangular column also. So there is a lot of type of cross section and you can use this cross section for your beams and columns. I'm choosing the rectangular one. Now you have to input the cross sectional dimensions in these two boxes. I'm inputting YD as 0.45 and ZD as 0.45 also. Then I will click on add option. As I click on add option, your property is being added in your property dialog box. That means it is defined. If you want to create another cross-sectional property, then you have to close it. Now it's time for assigning our property to our structure. There are four ways for assigning property to our structure. You can choose any of these. If you already selected your beams or columns, then you choose the first one, assign to selected beams. As I didn't select yet, it's a dead option. And from this option, assign to edit list, you can input the beam number to a list and the property will be assigned to that beam. We can use our cursor to assign also. And from this option, assign to view, you can assign your property to the total structure. I want to use this option, assign to selected beams. To use this, first of all, I have to select my columns. To select my columns, I will go to select option. Then here there is an option, beams parallel to Y. As my columns are on Y direction, so I am clicking on Y. Then my columns have been selected. Then my option is alive now and I can click on assign option. Then I click on yes. Then you can see that my property have been assigned to my columns and we can see that from this number. This is reference 1 and here this is reference 1 number. So this cross section has been assigned to these columns. We will talk about material later, so don't think about this material. We're just assigning property to our beams and columns in this video. If we go for 3D render now, then we can see that our columns are not lines anymore. They have gotten a cross section and that is a rectangular cross section. Similarly, we will assign property to our beams also. To do that, we have to define our property first. And for that, I will go to this define option and I will choose the rectangular cross section again. And I will input the dimensions as 0.3 by 0.3 and keep the material as it is. We will discuss about material in detail in next videos. So I'm done and I will click on add option and I can see my property in my property dialog box. So I'm done and I'm closing it. Now I have to assign this property to my beams. For that I have to deselect these columns first. I am clicking on my workspace. Then my columns are not selected anymore. Now I will select my beams. So I am going to select option then go to beams parallel to X, and again I will go to select option, then beams parallel to Z, then my all beams will be selected. Then I will go to assign, I'm clicking on it, then I will click on yes. Then my second property have been assigned to my beams. If I go for 3D render, then I can see that my beams are not lines anymore, they have gotten a cross section and looking like a real beams. So let's close it now and click on workspace. We have assigned properties to our beams and columns. Now it's time for plates or slabs. We will assign property to our slabs of our structure. Slabs only have thickness. To give thickness to our slabs, I have to go to this option, thickness. I'm clicking on it, and now I can input the thickness of my slab. I will input same thickness. I am clicking here and giving here 0.15. then I will add. As I add, I can see the plate thickness here, and I'm closing it. Before assigning the plate thickness, I have to select the plates first. To select plate, I have to go select option, then I will go to plates parallel to XZ. Then my all plates have been selected. Now I can use this option, assign to selected plates. I will click on assign, then I will click on yes. Then I can see R3, that is plate thickness. This is reference 3 number property, and I can see R3 for my plates also. If I go for 3D rendering, then I can see that there are two plates and they have gotten a thickness, and it is looking good, and I am closing it. So my beams, columns and plates or slabs, whatever you say, they have assigned their properties. And if I go for 3D render now, then I can see my whole structure. Unfortunately, my top floor slab have been not assigned. So let's close this 3D render view. Then let's zoom it little bit. And I will select this beam. Then I will press Ctrl and select this beam also. And I will click on this option, then on plates have been created. I am clicking on OK. Now I will assign my property to this plate. To do that, first of all I have to select my plate. To select plate, I will activate my plate cursor, then I will click here, then my plate has been selected. Now I can click on this assign option, I am clicking on it, then I will click on yes. Then I will go for 3D rendering. Now I can see my plate here. Let's close it and click on workspace, and now I will go for 3D rendering. Now there is no problem, I can see my structure, that everything is okay. Let's make it beam cursor and double click on any beam, then you can see the property. It is 0.45 by 0.45, and if you go to property, you can see your dimensions also. Later we will talk about materials, so just keep it as it is, and I'm closing it. So this is all for property in StatPro, and this is all for today. If you have any problem or if you face any trouble, then please comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing, see you in the next video.